Hi, this is Graham from Jenham's Astro. Those of you who look at the videos on my channel will probably already know that I'm a big fan of the Celestron C90 Maxitov scope. The purpose of this video is to see if we can make a small improvement to that scope using a simple and cheap material that you can pick up quite easily. Basically it's this, it's called flocking paper, and it is matte black paper. The idea being that it absorbs light, and we're going to use it to try and improve some of the image contrast that you get with the C90. Okay, so what problem are we trying to solve? Well, if we look down the front of the telescope towards the primary mirror, hopefully you can see there is, pointing out from the back of the primary mirror, there is a tube, and that tube points towards the secondary. Now, if I move the scope, you should be able to see a black plastic tube. That is the primary baffle tube, and the purpose of that tube is to make sure that we don't get any stray light reaching the eyepiece and affecting the image. Okay, so if we look from the eyepiece end, hopefully, if I move the scope left and right a bit, you can see, as we look along that tube, that there is some reflection from the inside of that tube, basically because it is not matte black. Okay, so what do we do? Well, we're gonna try and use the flocking paper to stop those reflections. So what I've done is I've cut a small section of the paper and I've rolled it into a tube. So here we go, there's the tube. You can do a better job than me, but this is just going to give you an idea. So if you look at the amount of reflections before, and then we're going to put the paper inside the scope. Okay, so hopefully you can see straight away that we've cut down on a lot of those reflections. Now, in my case, I haven't done a very good job, so I've not got a completely concentric tube. But if you do a better job, make sure that you're not cutting down any of the light that you do want, then I think it's pretty clear that that is gonna absorb a lot of the light that's touching that baffle tube. And we can see if that's gonna lead to any improvement in the image contrast. So in daytime use, on the left we've got the original scope, and on the right we have the same view with the flocking paper inserted. Same again here. This is looking at an object with a very bright sky background, so we're going to expect to have a lot of light potentially bouncing around on the side inside that baffle tube. And then finally, a view of some leaves again before and after the modification. Hopefully the improvement in the contrast is quite clear. So moving on to an astro target, this is a view of the sun. There's not a lot of activity now, we're close to the solar minimum, but I think you can see on the left and right a small difference in contrast. And if we take a still image from each of those two videos, I think the improvement is evident. The paper seems to have increased the contrast of this particular sunspot. And then moving on to the moon, in the early evening, the difference is quite clear. The sky is still quite bright at this stage, and the paper is giving us quite a good improvement. Whereas as the sky darkens, in this particular example, I'd say there is some difference, but it's not so great. So does this modification work? Well, I say yes, it does. Especially if you're gonna use the C90 in conditions where there could be quite a lot of stray light. So if you're using it as a spotting scope during the day, or if you're using it to view maybe the moon before the sun is setting, then you're going to see an improvement in the contrast. If you use the scope during night time, then I think for a very bright target like the moon, an extended object, You'll see some improvement in the contrast, but you won't see any real effect if you use it on and other objects. I haven't seen any real benefit when I've used it on Jupiter, for example. But overall, given that this is a very simple modification and it does yield some definite improvements, in some circumstances, I'd say give it a go, get some flocking paper and see if you get the same results as I do. Okay, thanks for watching.